Hello everyone, I am Chase of Rocky Mountain ATVMC giving you a closer look at the 5.5 Flex Lock boot from Leo. All right, everyone, thanks for checking in with us today. As you can see, we are talking about the new 5.5 Flex Lock boot coming from Liat. So this is Liat's first go at a premium boot. This boot, I think, is 2 years in the making, so they've done a lot of testing. They've had a lot of production runs, a lot of top riders wearing these throughout those 2 years just to make sure they get exactly how they want it. So I haven't ridden these yet. I am going to, so stay tuned for a ride review. But today, we're going to talk about the features, what makes these unique, how they give as much protection as possible, and also we're going to talk about fitment and what you can expect with the 5.5 Flex Lock. So first up, let's just talk about fit real quick. So I've tried these on. I've walked around in these here at Rocky Mountain quite a bit. I've had other riders try these on. We all say these fit true to size. It's actually a nice wide toe box. It's a very comfortable boot when you first put these on. The only thing I noticed when I put these on is on the lateral side here, and we're going to talk more about this, but just in between these two buckles you have right here, their flex system and their pivot system, I did feel a little bit of that plastic on my ankle. Now, I was actually kind of rolling my ankle around, really trying to feel what was going on. Is that going to affect me while I'm riding? I'm not sure. But other than that, it's actually a very comfortable boot, nice wide toe box. Now, keep in mind that with a boot, it's an apparel item, which means if you get the 5.5 Flex Lock or any boot that we sell at Rocky Mountain, if you're not happy with how it fits, you can send it back in brand new, unused condition, and we'll give you free shipping both ways on your first exchange. So we already talked about the toe box. Like I said, nice and low profile. You can see you've got hard plastic over top the toe box. You'll also notice too on the shifter side, what I like is they added a little bit of this texture here to give a little bit of added grip on the shifter. As you work your way up, you can see nice large shin plate, a lot of hard plastic here as well. And here's something that's pretty unique. First, we'll talk about the buckles. You got four buckle design. The buckles are going to be similar, I'd say, to an Alpine Stars buckle. If you're familiar with those, these are kind of along the same lines. You take your strap, slide it through the buckle, and then snap it down. So just out of the box, they work really well. Now keep in mind the straps and the buckles, these are replaceable. But you've got your four buckles, so I'm going to undo these. And if I open it up here at the top, here's what I like. They have what they call their slide locks, their slide lock cuff up here. So you look, you've got Velcro, but what's unique about this Velcro is that it's one way. So in other words, you can watch me. I will take this Velcro and actually slide it across, but then when I go to open it, that sucker is locked in there so it's not moving. And here's why I like that. It might seem simple, but for me, I think it makes a big difference. Because typically when you have a boot that has Velcro up at the top, here's what happens. You take the Velcro, you put the Velcro on, and then you cinch down your buckles. And when you cinch down the buckle, you'll kind of bind up or bunch up that Velcro right there. Well, because you can slide it that direction, that doesn't happen. So I really do like that they use that Velcro. It's pretty unique. So props to them for thinking outside the box, getting something new with the Velcro there. As far as the inside goes, you've got moisture wicking antimicrobial liner on the inside. No complaints there with that. You also do have some padding around the ankle area. And you'll notice too that they do have some impact foam underneath the heel and around that ankle area as well to help absorb as much impact as possible. So let me do these up real quick. So when we look at the lateral and the medial side here, you can see that there is a pivot system. You can see right here how this piece kind of goes up inside. So you have good flex out of the box with these. They are stiff, but you can expect that out of any premium boot right out of the box. But what's nice about these is I really don't feel like they're going to take too long to break in. We'll see how long that takes to break in. But out of the box, I'm going to give it, say, about a 7 out of 10 on the stiffness scale as far as the flexion goes front to back. But I think they'll break in just fine. But here's what's unique, and this is where the name Flex Lock is coming with these boots. You'll notice on the lateral side here, you can see this little red insert. So this insert is actually interchangeable. So when you get your boots, you'll actually have a second set that will come with these. Now, the one that's going to come installed in the boot looks just like this. You can see it's got a rectangle shape on the inside. The other set that will not come installed, you can see is actually circular. So what you can do is you can interchange these. So actually, I've already done this. I tried one boot on with the one that comes already in it. I put one of these in here, the round shape in there, just to feel the difference. Because what these do is they change the lateral rigidity or the stiffness of the boot side to side. So if you take the circular one, this is the stiffer setting, you put it in here, it will make the boot stiffer from side to side. Now when I did that, I put the boots on, Honestly, it was hard to tell the difference wearing the boots when I was trying to kind of roll my ankle side to side and feel the stiffness. But when I have the boot off and I'm sitting there and I'm going back and forth like this trying to feel that flex, it was noticeable when I did that. So it does make a difference when you have this stiffer setting in there. Now again, that's just gonna come down to rider preference. So what I would recommend, put them in there. Don't just not do it because it takes a little bit of time. It's real simple to do. You can see right here on this little ridge here, or where that insert is, you have this little bracket, you could call it, that comes over. You're gonna undo these two screws here, then you're gonna undo the two screws on the back here that holds this little plastic insert in place, and that will allow you to take this out, put the other one back in. So it's pretty unique that they're allowing you to adjust the flex laterally of the boot. Never seen that in any other boot on the market. So pretty cool that they're doing that. Now, one claim that Liat makes with this flex lock system is that this actually, they say, helps reduce about 35% of forces to the rider's ankle and also to the rider's knee. Now, I actually was wondering, well, how does that help with the rider's knee? And what they explained to me is that obviously when your ankle is rolling side to side, those forces get transferred to your knee as well. So the more support you can give to the ankle inside the boot, the more it's gonna help the rider's knee as well. Also, you're gonna notice too, it's pretty unique, you actually have some vents on this boot just to help these things breathe as well. If you look at the back here also, you'll notice you've got right here kind of a two-piece system. You've got the back of the calf, and you notice that you have this, you could call it an insert or a tongue that goes up inside there. So this is allowing the boot to flex. You can actually see that working. And what I like about that is when you get to a certain point, you'll actually feel it hit a stop up inside there, and it will help reduce that hyperextension. So it flexes to there, and then it stops. So you can actually really feel that working, doing what it's supposed to do, which is again helping protect your ankle from hyperextension. We already mentioned it, you do have some good padding inside the ankle area as well to help absorb that shock. As far as the medial side goes, they made this thing as flat as possible, and here's what I like. You can see you've got that hard plastic wrapping around the inside, but once you get to right here, this second piece, this is a much grippier rubber compound. So down here, it's your typical hard plastic TPU, but up here, much grippier. So I actually think that's going to do a great job of gripping the bike when you are out there riding. As far as the sole design goes, here's what's cool. As you notice right here on the inside, kind of where the arch of the foot is, you see all these little dots? That is actually a harder compound than the rest of the boot. So they increase the durability of the sole where it really matters, where you're going to be contacting the foot pegs the most. You also do have a CE certified steel shank. Again, that's going to come up about halfway, and that's just going to add some extra support for the riders, or for the foot inside there. And also the insole on here is replaceable as well. So a lot of replaceable parts. I like that the sole, they've beefed up the durability where it counts. And overall, I think it's a rock solid boot. I think they did a good job. I'm curious to go ride in these and see how they perform, how the feel in the foot pegs is, but I really don't think I have anything too much to be worried about when it comes to that. Now, as far as pricing goes on this boot, you're gonna be just shy of $400, which for me, I think is really fair. I've seen riders like Justin Hill, Vince Freese, Ryan Sipes wearing this. So if you can get a premium boot that top level riders are wearing that comes in sub $400, that to me is a good value. If you guys have questions or comments about the new 5.5 Flex Lock boot from Liat, leave those below. We'll get those answered. And to pick up your set, you can just click on the link or head over to RockyMountainATVMC.com. As you can see, you got some cool different colorways that you can choose from. Also, check out the Liat riding gear. They've got gear, they've got helmets, you know, really cool stuff coming from those guys. They're obviously known for their protection gear. So check out their wrist deflectors, their knee braces, all the other great products that are coming from Liat. Orders over $75, ship free. If you guys like this product spotlight, you want to see more just like it, make sure to get subscribed to our YouTube channel, and that's going to keep you up to date. I am Chase, and we'll see you on the trails.